Hello, this is Dr. Gary Hawkins with the University of Georgia Crop and Soil Science Department and UGA Extension. Today we'll be demonstrating how to use the Water and Wastewater Enviroscape model. Funding for this video has been in part from Georgia's EPD 319 program. In this video, we will use the Water and Wastewater Enviroscape model to show how wastewater is collected, treated, and disposed. This video can be used in conjunction with the Watershed Enviroscape to further explain the wastewater treatment plant on the Watershed model. As we get started, let's remove the streets and trees so that it'll be easier to see what we are showing. Notice the model has two channels. The blue channel is for our water lines, and the clear channel is for our wastewater. So in this video, we'll be focusing specifically on the clear channel to learn about wastewater processing. Now, when you're setting up your model, make sure that all the buildings with holes in the top go over your clear sewage channel. But for this demonstration, I'll just remove the city building so we can get a better idea of the whole system. As we start looking at the sewage side, again, sewage pipes are located underground, and that is the reason to start with the streets in place and then remove them. It is also important to realize that sewage is moved in pipes and not in open channels. Water flows downhill, so our wastewater treatment plants are typically at the lower side of the city or the community and located next to a creek, which is at the lowest point of the watershed. By placing the wastewater treatment plant at the lowest most point of the watershed, gravity is used to move all the sewage freely downhill to the wastewater treatment plant. If there has to be either long distances or there is a little bit of elevation change, there may be some pumps or pumping stations along the sewage line, but this is typically just some pumps to help push the sewage to the wastewater treatment plant. Let's look at our wastewater treatment plant itself. On the model, it has a plastic covering, so we'll want to remove that so we can see what's going on inside. We'll use some red dye to simulate sewage that will be coming into the plant. Typically, we would use brown, but brown does not show up on the video as well as red, so we'll stick with the red today. As you can see, when we flush toilets, take baths, clean our dishes, or we do other things that produce a wastewater, it flows down our wastewater channel to our wastewater treatment plant. The first thing in our wastewater treatment plant is a screen. This is a real rough grit screen. It gets out a lot of the large particles. This can include things like toys, plastic cups, candy wrappers, or anything similar that gets into the sewage system. The screen is placed here at the beginning of the wastewater treatment plant to remove those large items. By removing these large items, the plant protects the downstream system, including the pumps and other parts in the wastewater treatment plant itself. After they're removed, these materials will then be taken to the landfill for disposal. Once the rest of the wastewater gets into the treatment plant, the first stage it reaches is a clarifier. So I'll put a little bit of water in here with our sewage that came down our lines. So in the clarification basin, this is where we add a lot of flocculation in the wastewater treatment plant. We add a flocculant or a coagulant in the system as well. Here in this system, in the waste treatment side, the coagulant actually helps a lot of the particles, the sand, the silt, the organic matter start coming together and congealing so large particles can settle out. So it goes from the first stage here. And as water comes down our sewage line, it'll be pushed from the number one on our model here, the clarifier, and then run into aeration basin. So I'll put some clean water to push it through our clarifier. At this point, we also have some air being introduced into the system. That air is introduced into the system to actually grow bacteria and microorganisms that actually help remove the organic matter from our treatment system. Now, on this model, you notice we have a blue plug on the side of the aeration tank. I'll leave the plug in for today's video, but if you want to, you could remove the plug and as our primary clarifier and our settling basin fill up. It would then move into a secondary clarifier. This is where the sludge would be removed and the water would become clearer. We can remove a lot of the sludge and organics at this point. The sludge could be removed to our lagoon system here on the model. From the lagoon, it would go into our anaerobic digester, and I'll talk about the anaerobic digester here in a minute along with our incinerator. Now, one of the other things you could do with the sludge is take some of the sludge material out of the secondary clarifier and put it back into your second stage aeration basin so that you'll really just kind of refeed the aeration basin with these bacteria. Those bacteria then will continue to feed on the organic material and allow us to have a good removal system for the organics. From the secondary clarifier, the water that would come out up here would be relatively clean at this point. There may be a few bacteria left in the water, but in essence, it is clean and clear. From here, the water would travel to our chlorate chlorination and dechlorination basins. It would run into our chlorination basin first, and I'll go ahead and add some water here, so it'll run out of our secondary clarifier into our chlorination basin. Sometimes there may be a filter between chlorination basin and dechlorination basin. This would get out any remaining organics or large particles that would be there and help filter out some of the chlorine residuals. It would then go into the dechlorination basin where the water gets the final cleanup of all its residuals. There's a plug here that would let the water go straight to our creek or our river system. Now, a wastewater treatment plant would have an Npdes permit, or National Pollutant Discharge Elimination System permit, to discharge some pollutants and some contaminants. But these would be very small amounts back into our creek system. This water would eventually make it back down into our lake. Now, if this community was upstream of another city miles down the river, we would come back to our water treatment plant before going into the city's homes and offices. You can look at the process in one of our other videos. Now, if we go back to the anaerobic digester from earlier, the lagoon sludge that we took from the clarifiers can go into the anaerobic digestion system with the help of some anaerobic bacteria. They can actually convert the organics into methane and carbon dioxide. The interesting thing about the anaerobic bacteria is that these bacteria work without the presence of oxygen, so they don't need oxygen to help break down the organic material. The methane they produce can then be used back in the plant as fuel if it was clean enough, or it could be put into our incinerator here on site. The incinerator could take some of these solids and actually burn that material using the methane from the anaerobic digester or another outside fuel source. The remaining sludge out of the anaerobic digester can then be put into a truck. This truck could be taken over here to our farm, and we could actually apply biosolids to our farms as a type of fertilizer. If you want to see more on that, you can look at our agricultural and non-point source pollution video. That is pretty much the process of our wastewater treatment system works on this model. Again, this has been Dr. Gary Hawkins with the University of Georgia Crop and Soil Science Department and UGA Extension. Thanks.